family and Vape Nation. We're on our way to go check out. Where are we going, Rich?
We're going to Trippy Tips.
Turn right to.
And what is a Trippy Tip?
Trippy Tip is a glass drip tip made by Bert Langdon.
And I got Bunny in the back, and she's vaping like a champ back there. And we're gonna go check out some Trippy Tips. So we'll catch you guys up here in a bit.
Sometimes I wake up by the door. That heart you got must be waiting for ya. Even now when we're already over, I can't help myself from looking for ya. But I set fire.
What a view, huh? This is the view from Trippy Tips. It's beautiful. It's a nice day. It's probably about 75, 85, somewhere in there. And it's really peaceful out here. This is Trippy Tips Bert. Got some Rich. Got some Bunny.
They get the O-ring section put on afterwards. So that's what we'll be starting with.
So it starts as a glass tube. And then it gets the O-ring put on afterwards.
Then you gotta pick your colors. I got the color wheel going on up here. Sort of. And I'm going to do something in blue because I like blue.
So that's all the color sticks?
Yep, we got color sticks, we got tubes that have been already pulled down with different colors on them and stuff. Pedal down here that you can make the fire bigger or smaller. So if you guys
are foot actuator,
give it a try. If you feel like you need more heat, just hit the foot pedal. Okay. So we got kind of a jagged edge on that guy. I'm just going to clean it off first. So I heat up a ring around the tube until it's nice and soft and moving. Blowing that nice orange, just take the tweezers and start pulling.
So the glass tube that you're holding, it doesn't get hot?
No. Okay, so you push it all the way up to about there before it starts getting warm. Yeah, glass is it's a really good insulator, so the heat doesn't like travel down it too much. I can put air in it. It's airtight. I'm going to use this chunk of silver that's on the end of this rod. And basically it's going to boil the silver. And then the steam that comes off of it gets condensed onto the colder glass. And that'll leave a color. That's one way that we do different colors. Left a nice silvery hue to it. And then if you do gold, you can get some of these colors. That's 24 karat gold. So there's lots of different ways to apply the different glass rods.
So you're not actually like what you just did, you're not actually, you're tinting the glass rather than baking it into the glass.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
So, I mean, it looks different if you look at it through the light, or if you look at it, the light shining on it. It'll give you different colors.
Totally.
Just kind of heating this guy up a little bit. Getting it soft before I apply it. Keep this guy warm in the flame, the tube warm in the flame. Start with a nice clean end on the rod also. Touch it instead of pulling it just by spinning, and because it's hot, it likes to stick to it. So, like, you know, if you were to just stick it to it, it's stuck on there pretty good.
If that happens and you don't want it to, just snap it apart. So, other ways that you can apply color to them would be to put little dots, or you can draw lines. Or you can kind of drag the glass around with other glass once it's on there. A piece of clear, solid rod.
So I'll just start heating this up and raking it.
Okay.
Starts bending a little bit, it's okay. Gravity is the best tool. You know, there's all these tools they sell for glass blowing, like tweezers and carbon reamers and scissors and runners and all this stuff, but gravity is the best. Like, you see how that's kind of off? You just heat it up a little bit around where it's bent, and then just hold it there and it'll go back to straight. The end of this is kind of, it's got like a little bit of a clear spot where I didn't put any color or anything, which I don't like, so I'm going to take and just kind of peel that clear spot off and make all of those lines come to a point.
As
you're getting it hot, it likes to sink together and become more even. Blow it out a little bit. If you want to manipulate the glass by spinning it, you can attach another rod by welding it on there, and then use it to twist one side or the other side. And that's how you get like the zigzag sort of patterns. So I'll do a little bit of that on this too. Just heat up a ring of it. is a pretty complex design. So it's getting more and more complex the more you
play with it. Now we do our off-axis technique. And basically I'm going to blow a ball. And then I'm going to pop a hole in the side of it. And after the hole is popped, I'll attach another tube to it. So then you'll get that cool design that I made by pulling this off on either side of the tip.
These are stay at home in front of the computer tips.
Yeah.
Not take with you to work. So you're just pulling on it to kind of flatten it out, or is gravity making the glass fall?
I'm mostly just heating it.
Okay.
I am pulling a little bit. I'm trying not to twist the design at all, which is really hard because when you're moving a big tube and a little
needle,
they want to naturally move at different
angles. Right.
Like the spinners like that, it's pretty quick.
Yeah.
Versus like...
Right.
A lot slower.
So you almost have to let one roll on your hand as you pull with the other one, right?
Yeah, you got it. I'll make sure that it's well done really well. Thank you.
sits really low on the lips. And really comfortable.
So the bubble portion that you did, the purpose of that was to get that bubble in the bottom?
The bubble?
The axis you were saying?
Oh, the switching the axis was...
so that you're changing the direction of the way that the lines were going?
Right.
Okay, yep.
You got it. So then what started off as the very tip of that first bubble will end up right here now.
Okay, that makes sense, yeah.
You can see all those lines that I made come together.
Totally, you just reversed the direction of the design.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, totally, that's cool.
And it makes for some really interesting...
Look, that's how he takes the picture of the wood. He does a little thing like that.
Oh, okay.
So these are the trippy the tip tips right that I made?
Takes the picture, puts it on the side.
That's smart.
And these are probably what they look like before they're totally finished into this?
Yeah. No, all I was saying was that, just based on what Bert was doing before, I mean, the observation that was going through my head was that you go through the price of different drip tips in various sites, and you see the price differential between, let's say, for example, getting a trippy tip from Bert and getting, like, you know, just your regular run-of-the-mill drip tip that could be, like, factory produced for a lot less money. But the reason why the cost is more than justified because, one, the education Bert went through to, like, learn these skill sets. Two, the amount of time it takes for him just to make one tip, all the steps that are going through. It's not just something that is that looks beautiful, has good functionality when you're vaping. I mean, you're vaping a piece of art, you know, something that is a collectible, that's something that, you know, that when used correctly and you have proper means that proper means with can last, you know, for a long period of time, and you know who it's coming from, and now you understand the effort it goes through. So I'm just saying that when you see the prices on it, you know you're getting your money's worth when you purchase one of these tips.
Yeah, there's a reason why these tips cost the way they do. If you look at this shop, there's a lot of tools in here. You got your gas for the torch, you got your torch, you got your color sticks, you got all your glass for the color, for the tips, this machine that cools down your stuff, this guy's time, education, artistic ability all needs to get paid for. He takes pictures of everything that he does, and when you get a final product, it's been very carefully handmade with precision and artistic ability, and that all costs money. And these are beautiful pieces of artwork. Where do they get your drip tips?
Trippytips.com, and we have links to our other vendors that help us out with selling them for us also at the bottom of the page.
Cool. Trippytips.com, everybody. Make sure you guys go and check them out. They also have vendors that they do wholesale for. So this is DJ J-Rock and Snow Bunny and Rich. And we're all signing out. Thanks for watching. You were interested in, or just something you kind of fell upon? So how long did it take you to actually get the hang of it to be able to do so?
Oh man, I still don't have the hang of it.
You
damn. Give it a little
you just want to make sure it doesn't start to collapse on itself, you know? You don't want to, like, blow it out into a bubble yet or anything like that. You just want to keep the same amount of air.
And if you want, man, get that foot pedal on. Use the big fire.
So how much gas stuff do you go through? What do you call that? Is it gas?
Gas?
Yeah, how much
do you
like?
All together today, we maybe went through 50.
Okay. 2,000. Yeah, that's not bad. Is that expensive to retail?
We just run about 20 bucks at least.
Okay. Oh, that's not
that's
bad.
That's not bad.
And we got the grill flipping up there. This is oxygen.
Okay. Not bad at all. My stuff was on an oxygen tank and they charged me like up the butt.
Yeah.
Let's go buy one. That's so cool.
It feels good. in better shape here.
It did close?
Yeah, you made a marble, man.
Hey!
Oh, man.
No, don't worry about it. It's a glass. Yeah. So I'm just getting it all smooth, basically, now. So all that time is even.
And that's the tricks of the trade, where it comes in, what side to heat, where to heat it, how to turn it.
Right. See how it's getting all nice and into one uniform shape there. You see how it's closed, right? You see the inside?
Yeah.
Like where that bubble is?
Yeah.
Okay. Uh-huh. So how do you fix that kind of thing? You just blow?
Yeah, he blows air into it. See his bubble going bigger?
Yeah.
Wow. So you're watching you're watching the bubble, you're not watching the glass.
You're blowing in?
Right, yeah. Blowing in.
Okay.
Oh, okay, I was blowing the right direction.
I want to go to those conventions where they go.
There you go, you're following.
Do it. You should learn it.
So cool.
And then give it a little pop. You can see it in play. Heat it up again.
Is there ever a point where you cup too much of it first?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
You don't want to do that.
Okay.
But if you do, it's no big deal. This looks way better than the first thing I made, I'll tell you. Whoa. Did you just suck in on it?
Yeah, suck in.
Whoa. So you're gonna end up with a really trippy design after this.
You're gonna have a real trippy tip.
Yeah.
It's the one and only power tip.
Oh,
mistakes usually come out the best, though.
Yeah, I'm telling you. That's how I learned a lot of designs. On accident. Are you good?
Oh, cool.
Yeah. This looks really cool.
Yeah, no more sucking.
He's all sucking on it.
Gonna get it even for you.
Okay. So I think I'm done with the color.
Okay.
I'm totally done with color. I think I'm with the shape. I'm gonna go to the shape.
Okay.
So shaping,
you can blow into it, you can push down with the knife, you can use the paddle to kind of squash it, you can smash it on there, you can do lots of different things. Just heat up the parts you want to move, though. Oh, you can also attach, attach to it, pull on it, or push on it. Yeah, let's start with it.
Can you just push something through there? Or how do you think
this goes? So once you have a ball like this, say pop a hole on either side.
Okay.
And you push two holes together.
Okay.
And then you melt it all together. Wow. So you weld the two holes
together. Okay. Wow. Nice.
Well, easy to put it back in the fire.
It looks a lot different down here than it does from standing up.
Right? I need like a GoPro with one of these lenses on it. There you go, now cut it. Yeah, you got it, man. And what color do you want to use? I didn't even ask before we start.
I'll make her one for her birthday.
Okay.
So maybe like a pink and purple?
Yeah, yeah.
And purple? Yeah, do the color.
Like, do you have like a clear? Like a secret pink or purple?
Yeah. Yeah, this is it. And then go my time. So when we pull down to a usable, okay, you have the push button on.
Yeah. Now do I hold that down or does it might click on and off?
It clicks on and off.
Okay.
I'm just gonna heat it up a section. And you'll be able to see what colors this turns. You know, it reacts with the flame chemistry,
okay,
and turns different colors. So I know you said pink and purple, but
that's
this
still,
doesn't look like either.
That's still pretty awesome. Just to have that different medium.
You can see it's a completely different color.
All right. Yeah.
So yeah, you can get everything from, you know, your purples,
yeah,
to your pinks, to your blues, to your greens, to your yellows.
Okay, yeah, definitely.
A whole bunch of different options out of this color.
That's cool.
And it's all about just how much you work it and how long you put it in the flame. I'll help you get it back to the pinks and purples
at
the end, because I've done it a few times. So, yeah. So you don't want to touch it above here.
Okay.
Other than that, you can pretty much just choke up on it.
And so do I want to work more towards the blue flame or
well,
up here?
The hottest part is right here.
Right.
And then as you go up, it gets cooler and cooler and cooler.
Right. Okay.
Even up here, though, you're still in the flame.
Okay.
So, you know, warm step up here, slowly, if you're coming back into the flame. But yeah, right there is a really good
spot. So how much of this do I actually want to heat up?
Maybe like an inch.
Okay.
You know, start on the tip, I guess. Start on the end, so it's not flopping around on you and that sort of thing.
I mean, you really get a...
That's warm, yeah, that's hot.
I know, it's
a little. You see the mirror on the film. And then now it's good. So you're gonna wanna hold it basically kind of under the flame.
Okay.
And then you get this really hot and apply it to that.
Okay.
Draw on it, you can do dots, you can twist it and make it swirl.
Wow, it takes a steady hand to get that even like you did.
Oh, I've done it a few times. See, it's kind of collapsing down a little.
Yeah.
Keep the thing up and blow into it a little. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Don't forget to blow it. That doesn't work. Oh, that looks so hard. The twisting part.
Right now, because it's so new, people are afraid of it.
So that's more scientific studies are coming out. So I think it'll be more relaxed. I think just right now, people are just completely paranoid. You know, thinking, oh my God, the big tobacco and pharmaceuticals, like, we're gonna move on, buddy. I don't think it's gonna be that way. It's really different. All the casual vapors, they just keep on by the discourses for each other. That's why some people are already just carrying, like, for example, the suppliers have already figured out a way to just sell the flavoring to your hospitality, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've heard people that are like, you know, they're going to start stockpiling and make a team and anything.
Well, I do have a half gallon of a kick in my house.
I got a half liter.
Huh?
I said I got a half liter.
Got a half gallon of it.
I'm talking about like going through an extra bedroom.
I'm going to turn that extra bedroom into like my room for mixing and everything. I'll put all my baking supplies in there. I'll be my baking room.
Yeah.
And eventually I'll have a house. Well, I will have a house soon. Because my brother and I are investing in a home building problem.
Yeah.
Sugar land?
Yeah. Sugar, yeah.
Isn't it Houston metro area, basically?
Stuff you had on earlier was just fine.
I wouldn't let Rich give me that answer when I asked him. So.
Oh. Yeah. Let's do some Eagles. Do you have Eagles?
Eagles?
Yeah. Do you like the Eagles or no?
Yeah.
Do you have the Eagles?
I guess you're going to have the Eagles.
Bye. coldness about.